Hey guys, welcome to this video on how to cross-multiply fractions. When cross-multiplying fractions, the name sort of hints at how this is actually done. You literally multiply across. Let's say you have two fractions that are set equal to each other. So let's say A over B is equal to C over D. Well, to cross-multiply them, you multiply the numerator in the first fraction times the denominator in the second fraction. Then you write that number down, D. Then you multiply the number in the numerator of the second fraction times the number in the denominator of your first fraction. Then you write that number down. The reason we cross-multiply fractions is to compare them. Cross-multiplying fractions tells us if two fractions are equal or which one is greater. This is especially useful when you are working with larger fractions that you aren't sure how to reduce. Let's take a look at some numerical examples. So when we cross multiply, when we set it equal, and then cross multiply these two fractions together, we get 128, so 4 times 32 is equal to 128. And when we cross multiply these two, we get 7 times 26, which is equal to 182. So we know that 7 over 32 is greater than 4 over 26 because 182 is greater than 128. We must always remember that the number that we multiplied with our numerator represents that corresponding fraction. So this number is representing this fraction, and this number is representing this fraction. I mention this because it may be a little confusing to see numbers taken from two different fractions being multiplied together, but the product only representing one of the fractions and not the other. 128 goes on the left side to represent 4 over 26, and 7 times 26 is equal to 182 goes on the right side to represent this fraction right here. Cross-multiplying fractions helps us to see if numbers are equal, and if not, which is bigger and which is smaller. But that is not its only use. Cross-multiplying fractions can help us to solve for unknown variables in fractions. Let's say we have two fractions. We can cross-multiply any time we have a fraction that is set equal to another fraction. Now, to cross-multiply, we do the exact same thing that we did in our last example. We take the numerator of one side and multiply it times the denominator of the other side, and do the same thing for the numerator of the other side. In this case, we multiply 9 times 27 and 16 times our x. This would give us 243 is equal to 16x. Now, all we have to do to get x by itself is divide both sides by 16. This cancels out, and this gives us x is equal to 243 over 16. And you can simplify this even further. Now, we would do this exact same thing even if x is in our denominator. It doesn't matter. I hope that this video over cross-multiplying fractions has been helpful to you. If it was helpful and you would like further help, you can subscribe to our channel by clicking below. See you guys next time.